Welcome back to my channel Tutorials. Today in this video we are going to see Angular decorators. So why we use a decorators in Angular, so what is the use of it, what are the different types of decorators we have in Angular. So briefly I want to gonna explain all these kind of things in my video. So this is one of the parts in Angular. So previously we have done so many parts, like what are the concepts before we have to know, before knowing the decorators. So components, directives, and how to create your first application, all these things we have done videos previously. So watch those videos before you getting started into this video, so that will definitely help you to know the things better. And links are in the description, you can check it out. The course, Angular course link is there, and also other playlists also there. We have done HTML, CSS, and all other web development concepts kind of thing. Check out all the playlists, so any one of the playlists may help you to get the things better. So other than other explanations which you can see in the YouTube. So after that you have to do one more thing, that is to get the notifications or to get the other instant updates about the video uploadation and all the kind of things. You have to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will never miss any update from us related to next videos we have doing in Angular, or any other concepts we are doing, or any other information we have to give to our subscribers. You will get to know only by clicking on the bell icon so that you will receive notifications. And like this video before getting started, so that will boost up me if I get any likes for this video, so that I will understand like my concept is going well, people are understanding likewise. So if you give me the reaction only, then I will got to know, right? So what are the things I have to improve and everything, you have to comment in the comment section. I will take your comments and improve my standard of giving information likewise. And share this videos to your friends. Like I am explaining everything in detail, like Angular course is a very vast course, like I am explaining everything in a clear manner. So let's get started in Angular decorators. So Angular decorators are the one thing which we use it mainly to store the metadata about any class or method or property. So I will show you practical examples so that you will understand and you will bluntly remember what decorators are. So I use this Stackblitz website, which is a very cool website where we can create any JS environment within milliseconds. So this is only for JavaScript kind of environment, like JavaScript we can use for front end and also for back end. So I have made a video on this Stackblitz website overview also, like how we can create any other applications like React and everything. So go to my playlist and you can check this video also. So in my videos you will find this, and I also give you the link in the description so that you can easily find that video. So Stackblitz for review I have given. So here after clicking the Angular part, I get an application, like components are there, and also module is there, app module is there where component is declared. So hello component is one more component we have, and that what we are using in HTML as a customized the custom directive. So all these things we have done in the previous videos, check out those videos. So now what we are doing is decorator. So decorators is nothing but we can call it as a data annotations or metadata or annotations, like all these names we can call it as a decorators only. So it's a different kind of name we called decorators, because this is provides the metadata, the extra information about the class or property or method. So extra information we are giving for that particular thing, that is nothing but a decorator. So when you configure a component, like you are providing a metadata for the class, that tells Angular that a component is a specific configuration. Okay, so for example, see, we have different let's see the example so that you will understand types of examples. Class decorators are there, for example ng module and ng component. Let's see within a practical example. Here we have app component, we know app component.ts file is there. Here one class is there that is called as an app component. By giving the component name as component, that doesn't recognize that particular class is of component type, like this is a Angular component. How that will recognize means by adding decorator before that class, so that it will understand that this is a component class or component kind of thing. So before the class we have to mention that it is a component type. Like @ symbol is nothing but a symbol for decorator. So @ component is an example for decorator. So when we say this, when we mention that @ component before the class, like app component, then it will consider this class as a component. Otherwise, if this part is not present, it doesn't consider as a normal TypeScript class, but it doesn't consider that as a component. So to make it considered as a component, you should give some metadata to that particular class. That is @component, that this class is called a component class likewise. So in that component, we have selector, template, URL, styles, and this thing. So @component of this is nothing but a decorator. We called as @component is a decorator that gives metadata about this class, which is this Angular component. This normal class has become as an Angular component when we add this decorator, that is @component. You can see similarly the other example for class kind of here. You can see class decorator sort of ng component we have seen now. So ng module, you can see modules are there. App module.ts file is there. Here you can see here also we have a class that is as app module. The name of the class doesn't tell you that it's a module or kind of, you can give any name, right? If you have created another any kind of a module, the name will be different. So so at that time, what that will make that class as a component is @ng modules. By mentioning this decorator here, @ng module, that will make this class app module as a module. So it will consider now it as a module class. So unlike there is no ng module, it will consider normally as a TypeScript class only. Doesn't consider that as a module class. To make it as a module class, we have to use this decorator before this class, that is ng module, where we have a different kind of properties, right? Imports, declarations, bootstraps. These properties may differ for decorator to decorator, where we have the component decorator have these kind of properties, and whereas ng module folder has this kind of properties like imports, declaration, bootstrap. So this is called ng decorators, ng module, and ng component, which is a class decorators. Like here we are giving extra information about the class. So we have other things also, like what properties also we can give extra information, like we can configure the default kind of things there. So like you will understand this point now after seeing this example. So it will provide the metadata for the class that tells Angular that this component has a specific component. This class is related to a module class. This class is related to component class. By mentioning this decorator that has a base configuration with some default values are there, like a template or selector, some default values. So when the decorator is created using the relevant factory, the default configuration is passed. So that will consider that as a module class or a component class that make the configuration here. So decorator is used for specifying the configuration, giving meta information about the method, class, and property. Like class, we have seen example. So see the properties. So properties also we can give like input and output. So some, you can see here in the Stackblitz, you get an default one example, like a hello component they have created. Further, they have used a property called as name, which is of type string. Here you can see @input. So this is the string, @input is nothing but it is telling the metadata, which is previously to the property. So before mentioning the property, I have given this @input. So whenever @ comes, we can consider that as a decorative here. So whenever the decorative is, it's giving extra information about that property. So this property is an input property for this component. So whenever we use this component selector, we have to provide that input property so that the name will take that input, and according to that will give the output template here. So hello and name will be printed here. So likewise, to understand better about this hello component, you have to refer my video called as a custom directives, where I have explained how to use this like how to use component as a directive, or by using the selector in the other component. I have explained all these things in a clear manner. So watch this video. In this video, just up to knowing about input parameter, like we are giving meta information like input property, this is output property, like I'm adding extra information to the property, then it is called as a property decorator. So @ should be mandatory to know it is a decorator, right? So next, method decorators. So now we have given told like this is a this of input type or output type as a property. You can have methods also. For example, I have one method like as a hide method or a submit method, likewise all those things. So before writing this method, you can give @, so like that. So @, here you can see host listener. Host listener is the one example for a method kind of things. Host listener, we have to give, like we have to mention like whenever, when we have to listen to this particular method, like or whenever the click happens, or like events you can mention for the particular method. So then it is nothing but a method decorator. So for methods also, before methods we can write the extra information like when it is called, like when you have to listen likewise. So that is nothing but a host listener example for method decorators. So parameter decorators we have, that is @inject. So to understand each and every example, I will make another videos for that. So here basically I understand the types of decorators. To understand about these kind of things is most important. So video becoming lengthy, so I'm stopping here. So basically Angular decorators is a thing which is to store the extra information, and so basically this parameter injector is used for in the constructor level. I didn't tell you. So at the constructor level, we have automatically defining that classes, right? So at the constructor level, at the time we use this injector. So in the further videos, I will show you the real example so that you will understand better. So this is all about Angular decorators. So I think everyone is clear with this. We have four types of things: class decorators, properties decorators, methods, and parameter decorators. So ng module is a basic thing which tells it is classes of module type, and ng component. Edit component tells that is classes of component. Otherwise, Angular will not recognize that is as a component or module kind of things. So the previous videos also I have done what is meant by module and what is meant by component. I have done videos. So check out all those videos. That will definitely help you to know the things better and understand the Angular concept better. So that's all for this video. If you like this video, give a big thumbs up below and share this videos to your friends and colleagues who don't know about exactly what this decorators means in Angular. And keep watching our videos and stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.